Good evening, everyone, and welcome to East Midlands Synod Prayers for Tuesday, the 22nd of March. O God, make speed to save us. O God, make haste to help us. Your word is a lantern to my feet and a light upon my path. Your decrees are my inheritance forever. Truly, they are a joy to my heart. How sweet are your words to my taste. They are sweeter than honey to my mouth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. And on Tuesday evenings, our psalm is Psalm 121. I look up to the mountains. Does my help come from there? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will not let you stumble. The one who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel never slumbers or sleeps. The Lord himself watches over you. The Lord stands beside you as your protective shade. The sun will not harm you by day and the moon by night. The Lord keeps you from all harm and watches over your life. The Lord keeps watch over you as you come and you go, both now and forever. Amen. And our song this evening is Before the Throne of God I Stand.
With Christ my Saviour and my God.
And this evening, I've chosen the evening psalm from the list of readings. So the evening psalm is Psalm 25, a psalm of David. In you, Lord, my God, I put my trust. I put my trust in you. Do not let me be put to shame, nor let my enemies triumph over me. No one who hopes in you will ever be put to shame. But shame will come to those who are treacherous without cause. Show me your ways, Lord. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are God, my Saviour, and my hope is in you all day long. Remember, Lord, your great mercy and love, for they are from old. Do not remember the sins of my youth and my rebellious ways. According to your love, remember me, for you, Lord, are good. Good and upright is the Lord, therefore he instructs sinners in his ways. He guides the humble in what is right and teaches them his ways. All the ways of the Lord are loving and faithful towards those who keep the demands of his covenant. For the sake of your name, Lord, forgive my iniquity, though it is great. Who then are those who fear the Lord? He will instruct them in the ways that they should choose. They will spend their days in prosperity, and their descendants will inherit the land. The Lord confides in those who fear him. He makes his covenant known to them. My eyes are ever on the Lord, for only he will release my feet from the snare. Turn to me and be gracious to me, for I am lonely and afflicted. Relieve the troubles of my heart and free me from my anguish. Look on my afflictions and my distress and take away all my sins. See how numerous are my enemies, how fiercely they hate me. Guard my life and rescue me. Do not let me be put to shame, for I take refuge in you. May integrity and uprightness protect me, because my hope, Lord, is in you. Deliver Israel, O God, from all their troubles. Amen. Lent is a time of reflection. It's a time for us to do as David says, to lift up our souls. And this psalm, Psalm 25, begins with this great declaration of trust in God, before David goes on to name several issues and situations that he finds himself in that perhaps we can identify with. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. In you I trust, he says. And as we journey through Lent, it is good for us to affirm the foundation of our faith, to praise our God who guides us along life's path. And let's face it, they're not always straight. They're not always well-groomed. Now, Psalm 25 is one of those acrostic poems where the first letter in most lines begins with the succeeding letter of the Hebrew alphabet. And there are 22 letters in the Hebrew alphabet, and we find 22 verses in our psalm. And the use of this style helps the psalmist to paint a broad landscape with pathways that are detoured and overgrown with shame, with malicious acts, with a troubled heart, with entrapment, with loneliness, and with affliction. And within these paths is written, as it were, an instructional ABC of God's teachings, his forgiveness and his salvation. And what we notice is for every trouble or obstacle, there is an affirmation of God's grace. So, for example, when David implores God, "Do not remember the sins of my youth," it's countered with, "According to your steadfast love, remember me, O Lord." And so as we read Psalm 25, it is a soul-lifting moment that is filled with confidence and with hope. God is reminded, and we are reminded, of God's promise to be merciful and steadfast in love, while leading us and teaching us upon the paths we tread each day. So lift up your soul, give thanks and praise for God's steadfast love and trustworthiness. Let us pray. O God, help us to lift up our souls in praise to you because we can trust you. As we look to you for help, Lord, be gracious to us. Relieve the troubles of our hearts that we may receive your mercy. For all glory and praise be to you, Christ, our Redeemer. Amen. And our New Testament song is a song of love, which we find in 1 John chapter 4, 7 to 11. Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. This is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. This is love. Not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins. Dear friends, since God so loved us, we ought to love one another. Amen. And we come now to our evening prayers. Let us pray. Loving Creator of all, watch over us this night and keep us in the light of your presence. May our praise continually blend with the song of all creation until we come to those eternal joys which you promise in your love. Amen. Living God, we thank you that you are not just with us here as we pray, but you're also in the daily round of life, waiting to meet us, lead us, and bless us. Help us to glimpse your presence and not to close our eyes and minds to the work of the Holy Spirit in our midst, or to harden our hearts, but rather, Lord, to live each moment conscious that you are by our sides. Amen. Lord, we lift up to you the East Midlands Synods, and particularly tonight we pray for the ministers, the elders, and the members of our churches in Leicestershire. Where there is darkness, Lord, let them bring the light of your glory. Amen. And Father, we continue to pray for all those still facing the challenge of COVID-19, for strength and resilience and protection for all those responding in hospitals and care homes, and those who are administering the vaccination. We pray for those who are still suffering from COVID, long COVID, and we pray that they would continue to be strengthened and to be able to day by day do a little bit more. Alongside those who have physically suffered, we pray for those who have mental and health issues and have been so badly affected by the hardships and the changes that we've all faced in the last 2 years. Lord, we pray for peace, comfort and support for all those who have heavy burdens to bear on their own, alone, unbeknown to others. Lord, pour out your healing, pour out your comfort, pour out your peace, we pray. And Lord, we pray for all those who are worried when they look around the world, and especially for those who are worried about the facing rises at the cost of living, food, housing, heat, petrol and diesel, and so many other essentials. And Lord, we pray for all those caught up in conflict, whether forced to flee or fight or suffering the loss of loved ones, and especially for those afflicted in the conflict in Ukraine. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And I'd like to share with you a prayer for Ukraine by Thomas, Ireland's Church and Community Manager for Christian Aid. Let us pray. Lord of all people and all nations, we lift before you the people of Ukraine and the people of Russia. Each girl and boy, each woman and man living in the fear of what tomorrow might bring. We long for a time you spoke of through your prophet Isaiah, where weapons of war would be beaten into plowshares, when nations will no longer lift up a sword against nation. We cry out to you for peace. Protect those who only desire and deserve to live in security and safety. Comfort those who fear for their lives and the lives of their loved ones. Change the hearts of those who are set on violence and aggression. Fill earthly leaders with great wisdom to find paths of peace. Please, Lord, come and have your way in the world. May your will be done here on heaven, earth as it is in heaven. And may your peace reign now and always. And we lift this prayer to you, our God, who is able to do more than we can ever ask or imagine. In the name of Christ, our Saviour. Amen. And we continue to pray for healing and wholeness, comfort and strength for those who have asked for prayer, trusting that God hears our prayers and answers them according to his will, and offering us salvation through Jesus Christ, and making us whole and at peace with him. So we continue to pray with Celia for Alfie, with Liz for her great nephew Ryan, and for her daughter Emma, with Prince for Cheryl, with Andy for Mike, his dad, with Judith for her niece Catherine, and with Tom for his brother Steve's wife, Denise. We pray for the Reverend Ruth Dillon and for the Reverend Graham and Vera Mascree. Lord, bring your healing, we pray. And we pray for all those who grieve the passing of loved ones, especially for those grieving for Joan Allen and for those who are grieving the loss of the Reverend Michael Bond, especially for his members of his family and his friends at Long Buckby United Reformed Church. And in a moment of silence, Lord, we just lift up to you those we know who are in need of prayer tonight. Lord, we pray for healing and wholeness in each of these situations, according to your will. And we ask all these things in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. So may the Lord bless us with his grace and fill us with his peace. Amen.
Good night and God bless.